Give it up for Mr. Brad.
He started off as this sort of like Boy Scout kind of guy. Yeah.
You know, kind of straight-laced, yeah, goody-two-shoes a little bit. Troubled past, doesn't like to play with others. You know, that kind of thing. You know, your typical agent. And then they're like, hey, we want you to be a spy. And I was like, done. And then you don't have to shave anymore either. Cool. And I haven't shaved since.
All right, hey, we already covered that when someone starts getting scruff at a show, it's like, oh, they're going bad. Like, that's
so, Aaron, what is your excuse?
I am, like, long gone. He's just long gone. Your character was really the subject of the most secrecy because of the turns and the twists that you had. Did you ever screw up as far as say something in public that you were not supposed to say? Did you ever get a call from sort of the Marvel folks saying, like, yeah, Brett, you need to shut your mouth now?
No, I didn't, but Elizabeth did. I think somebody had sort of put two and two together about the whole Hive thing. And I think he spoke about it as good guests who want information out of people do. They're like, well, so since this is my impression. So since Hive is Hive, so like can you tell me more about like the whole process of that? And then I feel like I'm making fun of people, I'm not. Sorry. She got in trouble for sort of going along with that. She must have thought, like, oh, I guess it's out on deadline now. Yeah, so that's Hive, yeah. She got in trouble. Thankfully not me, though. Knock on wood.
Okay.
We'll see how this panel goes.
First time yet. Hi.
Hi. I just wanted to remind you how awesome you are.
Oh, thank you very much. Next question. Do we just keep the compliments going? I'm perfectly happy with that. We don't need to. Thank you very much.
Yeah, I just wanted to know that.
Handsome, charming.
Yeah, for sure.
Funny. Good fashion sense.
Funny.
Yeah. Let's just keep this going, guys. This is fun. Yeah. I don't know how fun it is for you, but I'm really enjoying it.
Since Shield's kind of in the back burner, like off now, and Gavin Stone's gonna come out, Lost in Florence. After those, like, what kind of role do you want to do next? Like, good, bad? I've heard dinosaur. You said?
Yeah. I do think the dinosaur community is underrepresented in the TV landscape, which I think, you know, we've had a few mishaps at, you know, a couple of parks. And for whatever reason, you know, people just don't feel like there is a need to put, you know, dinosaur lives at the forefront. I think it's a bit of a shame, but, you know, dinosaurs are people too, guys. So, that's something I'm very passionate about. I'd really like to see that in the future. But until that happens, until I get, you know, part to finally, you know, play Tyrannosaurus Rex, I would even go with a spitter. You know, those guys are cool too. Or even just like a brontosaurus. Like, those guys are really stego. I would love to do a stego. Those guys are really cool. Really, and a lot nicer than people think. Because they got all the spikes, but they're really soft creatures inside. Thank you. A lot of spikes, but good on the inside. I appreciate that. So, my next role, apart from the whole, crustacean period. Not crustacean period. Cretaceous, however. I'm hungry for lobster. I'm in Florida. I just thought, yeah. So apart from that,
where are we going?
I don't know.
Where are we going to see how far we can?
I don't know. How long do you guys have? I could be here all day. I don't know. I mean, I would just like to do something, a part that is different from the last one. I think that I have a lot to give and more than any one of these characters, you know. I'd like the opportunity to show that. I'd love to do an HBO show, Netflix. I mean, yeah, Hulu, Amazon, any one of these things are doing, you know, it is kind of the golden age for TV right now. Black Mirror, I don't know if you guys are watching that. I mean, any one of these shows, Westworld, I would love to do any one of these things. So, you know, if you guys are casting,
Let me know.
Sure, someone has a screenplay out here or something. Would you go back to, I mean, would it be your preference to go back to a 22-episode TV show, or would you like to do, you mentioned Netflix, would you like to film something that is like 8 and done and then dropped all at once?
That sounds cool.
Yeah.
That sounds great.
I mean, 22 episodes.
22 is a lot. It is a lot, yeah. And, you know, when the Netflix shows, you know, we had Constance Zimmer on our show, BJ Britt, both of those guys are now on the Unreal thing. I don't know if BJ's coming back for the third season, but both of those guys were done with their filming at a certain point. And they're like, hey guys, what are you doing? Still shooting? What are you doing? Done? Cool, that must be fun. So it is a lot, you know, it is a lot, but at the same time, there's stable employment.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. The world is my oyster at this point.
Yeah. Not a presentation.
Not a presentation. Yes.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hello. What was your experience playing?
Yeah.
What was your experience playing Grant in the TV show compared to your character in Until Dawn? What was the difference and similarities between those two worlds?
Between
TV show and video game.
Right. Do you know the songs?
I know them, but I can't sing them.
You got a mic, dude.
So for every question, we'll require someone to sing a song. So it's like sort of a bartering type of thing. Right? Oh, you want a question answered? Dance for us.
Now you know how I feel. Come on, man. You got a little. This is Halloween. This is Halloween.
There you go.
This is Halloween. This is Halloween. Halloween. Halloween.
Just agreeing to go on Mammoth. I mean, this is a guy who's had this, like, has been kind of bloodthirsty and vengeance hungry for so long, and he's like, I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna pop Coulson. And then, you know, Powers Booth comes along and is like, no, hop in that portal there. And I'm like, yeah, no. And I'm gonna finish this thing. And he's like, no, you gotta think of the bigger picture here. And so I think from then on, hopping into there, you know, he does kinda, he's seen the light in a strange way, like maybe he's part of something bigger. I think in a weird way, him dying is actually him winning. So by Coulson, again, straight up murdering me on another planet with his dinky little hand, I, in a sense, win. He becomes Ward. He becomes the thing that he says he's fighting against. And so, you know, hashtag winning.
So by him dying, he's actually winning.
Yes. I'm getting t-shirts printed.
Hi there.
Hi. It's a real reward to have you here.
Oh my goodness. That's very forward thinking. My favorite one is every once in a while, don't remind me of this honey scene, but every once in a while you have to do a shirtless scene and they give you a nice like silk robe to wear, and I always say that's my wardrobe.
My question is, do you have / had any dogs, and did you kill Buddy?
Whoa. No, I did not kill Buddy. Despite what, I mean, I don't, the whole thing, when we were filming that, I was like, so I don't kill him, right? Because if I do kill him, I'm irredeemable. They're like, no, you don't kill him. And then there's a whole bunch of references after that, like, no, he really did kill his dog. And so I don't know what to think, but if you're asking me, which you are, no. The dog? Come on.
Yeah.
Nor did I kill Fitzsimmons, even though I was ordered to. I pushed them out of a plane.
Whatever happens after
they can swim. Yeah. They're in a box. A giant box with a whole bunch of air. They'll figure it out. So, yeah, I did not. And have I ever owned a dog? No. My mom's not a dog person. So I've been a cat person.
Okay, cats.
I have three cats. And I've started to take up knitting. A little bit of needlepoint. Just a lot of, you know, Hydro was rebranding. We wanted just a nicer, softer image. And, you know, throw pillows were a big thing. Afghans. Just a whole bunch of stuff. You know, it's a lighter, friendlier side of Hydro. Yeah, exactly. And the skull thing, I feel like we should just change that into, like, happy face.
Still with the tentacles.
Squigs. Yeah, you know, couple of just make them all nice and neat, kind of almost like cursive flares.
Like Grandma Hydra. Like little Grandma Hydra, just knitting.
Yeah, all undercase.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Or like written in crayon by a kid or something. Like, these are all in brainstorming here.
Workshopping some marketing ideas.
Yeah. And obviously I'm not a head of Hydra anymore, but hopefully they'll hire me for the marketing department. I can have you. I don't think he'll fit this my luggage.
Feels going in a weird direction when people are just offering dogs. Like, how does your dog feel about that? Just take my dog, please.
He's sleeping.
Yeah.
He's just chilling.
He's not a fan of the show.
No, that's my biggest fan right there, actually. he's smelling a butt.
Former director Phil Coulson here. Yeah, May's got the bus, wings up, ready to go.
Anyway, to see her try.
Well done. Do you have this question? As a different genre, what's your thoughts about working in Christian films, since that's where you've moved on to now?
Yeah, well, I'm doing a film called The Resurrection of Gavin Stone. And it does have a faith element, but I hesitate to call it a Christian film. It's a Christian film in the same way that The Blind Side is a Christian film. that is a film that you could point to and go, oh, okay, there are some, like, you know, religious values in there, but it's first and foremost, hopefully, a good, heartwarming, inspiring film that just so happens to have kind of people taking care of other people. I'm not a regular churchgoer myself. I loved the script, and it's about a guy who is he's a former child actor who's really kind of messed up his life. The trailer's online now. Resurrection of Gavin Stone. And it's about a former child actor who's really kind of messed up his life, and he has to do community service. He does it at a church, and they're doing a play, and he's like, this is easy, I can phone this in, this is going to be great. He gets the role of Jesus Christ. And so a lot of it is like fish out of water comedy. Like, in a lot of ways, it's kind of poking fun at, you know, your church goer, and, you know, this is a guy who, this is a church where, like, everybody gets up and sings, and, like, you know, you can wear holes in your jeans and, like, come as you are kind of thing. So it's just a lot of fish out of water comedy and stuff, and he gets a second chance. So I don't know. I saw it as a redemption story for a guy who's down on his luck, rather than, like, you know, I'm Captain Christian now. So yeah, I hope a lot of people can enjoy it, though. And I know that this film, like, you know, my parents, especially my mom, you know, moms always just want to see their kids, like,
I just want to see you as a nice boy. What's with all the stuff? You should get together with Sky. You should. Stop doing this thing. What's with the, hide that. So she's gonna enjoy this film. I think my grandma's really gonna enjoy this film too. It's a feel-good film. I think it's impossible to walk away not feeling a little bit better. And so I hope you guys will enjoy it. And it's really funny as well. I get to be funny. Funnier than I am here. So it's really cool. So yeah, I hope that answers your question. I saw it as a good film first and foremost. Not really advocating for any one religion or another.
Well, thank you, Brian.
Thanks. Thank you.
Yeah, this is it's produced by or co-produced by WWE as well.
Yes, starring the one and only Shawn Michaels.
Yeah. Isn't it crazy that they are now producing movies? They've been doing the Marine movies. They actually. Like, nice quality. I've been to a couple of their sets.
Yeah,
actually, high quality sets and like totally. A tight operation.
Yeah.
Did you?
Blumhouse is behind it.
Oh, yeah. Well.
And they've produced a ton of your favorite films. Oculus was one of them, right? They did. And Walden Media is behind it as well. And it has 1,000 screen opening, which for an indie film is pretty darn good. So, a lot of people like it.
Did you go through the whole audition process for this flick?
I did, yeah. The thing with this one is, as I said before, I was like, I get this guy. It was written exactly like how I speak. I was like, if I don't get this guy, I want to find who's playing him and kill this guy. Because he's like way too similar to me. Like, I don't know who it is.
I'll teach you to feel good.
I was like, this like is me. Like, I get this. I can't do like every script that I've ever read. Sometimes it's like, you know, multi-camera comedy, and that's a different style. This, I was like, I can totally do this. I can hit this out of the park, guys. And then the callback scene was an audition monologue that I already had memorized. And I was like, can I just do this in the audition? And afterward, he was like, that's so funny, because I would have given you that for the callback.
Yeah.
So, and you already had it memorized? That's crazy. So it was just kind of, I guess, meant to be.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right.
First of all, I'd like to say that I think you're fantastic.
Oh, thank you very much. Let's start with compliments, okay? If you're going to ask a question, just start with compliments. Yes?
And then I'd like to ask, if you could travel in time, where would you go and why?
Well, if I could travel in time, wow. Oh, man. So many. Oh, gosh. I'd like to see Marlon Brando do Streetcar Named Desire on Broadway. Yeah, I would, that's, gosh, there's so many cool things, man, come on.
There's so many cool things.
Would you want to watch him do it at the beginning of his run, where he's still sort of figuring out that character, or sort of towards the end of that stage run where he's really got it locked down?
I think in the beginning.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, I think in the beginning. I've heard towards the end he was just, not like he was phoning it in or anything like that, but if he was tired, Stan Kowalski could be tired today.
Yeah.
No, it is. So, I don't know. Gosh, that just changed everything. Yeah. He's my favorite actor of all time, so. That would be the dream come true.
Let's go with that.
Yeah. would you want to take on a role, be it Stanley or one of his roles on stage, or is that sort of hands off?
Oh, that particular one is ruined. Nobody can.
I mean, you wouldn't even do it?
Like, no.
Okay.
No. No. Hmm. It's one of those things. You will never not be compared to Marlon Brando's version of Streetcar Named Desire. It's an uphill battle. Yeah, it'd be so, so difficult. Hmm. Unless you're a completely different like character type and you're doing it.
Even then, though, it's like, oh, you're trying to do the anti-Marlon.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Huh. Hi. In the vein of compliments, I really appreciate how genuine you've been with all of us.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I appreciate that.
So, my question is, what is the question you were hoping to be asked today, and what is the answer?
Not that question.
Oh, man. I thought somebody was going to ask me about, like, my action figure. Something like that. I like action figures. I'm starting to like Gambit a lot too. Like, I like the characters that, I don't know, Spider-Man, great, Hulk, great, Cap, awesome, but I like when they're just a little bit weirder than that, and I think Gambit's pretty awesome.
Real.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. I don't know if that answered your question.
Hi, mine's a bit, personal.
Okay, after the compliment, go ahead.
Okay, you did so well as Ward that two of my friends have now had dreams that I'm Hydra and are paranoid that the closest person to them is now turning to Hydra.
They've had dreams?
Yes, that I'm Hydra.
Wow. Oh. I'm not sure if I've ever dreamed about this show.
So well done,
you have scarred
my friend's life.
Yeah,
good job.
Wow.
This revealed
a lot about me.
Not
her,
I would never.
Why not? You have a point now.
My question is, I'm an actor, and I was wondering what play or film, since you do film, do you suggest that every single actor should read or watch? It's a loaded question, sorry.
Hamlet. Seriously. Because we often read this in high school, and it's often a required reading and stuff like that. But this is a guy who's questioning the nature of existence, his place in it, what it means to do something with your life. And he's, a lot of people think that he's like, I don't want to say lazy, but like, oh, he never does anything. But he's conflicted. He's indecisive for a reason. He's at that point where there's like when you're going into adulthood, when you're like kind of, I can't even describe it, but Shakespeare can. Damn it! And he does it so beautifully and so eloquently. And there's a reason why this text has survived. I mean, it is kind of gospel. You don't change anything about it. Every beautiful, incredible production of Shakespeare I've ever seen, they just do the play. They don't put it on the moon, even though you're dressed for the occasion. And it just works. And then when you grow up, you evolve and are like, this Hamlet guy, dude, I got mouths to feed. I got, you know, bills to pay. Like, stop your whining. And then you're like, yeah. Fortinbras is the guy who's really good. And so you start changing your allegiances and stuff. So that is something that is just foolproof, and I think that you can really connect to. I know that Shakespeare can seem kind of daunting and stuff.
I love Shakespeare.
Yeah. And it's meant to be seen. It's written to be seen. So if you're just reading it and it's not making sense, it's not you. Nobody in, you know, when he was writing, sat down with the text. All they had was their cue lines when they were up there on set, on stage. So they're really listening to each other, and they're really doing this play, and they're speaking with alacrity, and it's meant to be seen. So, yeah, it's not as inaccessible as you think. Go Shakespeare!
So I just got a 5-minute warning, so we have a lot of questions, and if we just keep things really brief, we can burn through a couple of them.
Okay.
All right.
We'll skip the compliments. Okay. Just the question.
Or just keep the compliments and no question.
Hi.
I was wondering what the most interesting or amazing thing you've gotten from a fan is.
Love.
All right, you're up, Lincoln.
What's up, Geeks of Color? I just wanted to ask, now that Fitz is working on live model decoys, do you think we might see Ward come back as a robot by chance in the future, season 4, late season 4, early season 5?
Two words. Hell yes.
Okay, you're awesome. And my question is, as an actor, what is... as an actor, what is like the best experience you've had working with a director? Like, obviously, someone is directing you and telling you like what, like you bring your part to the character and your director giving you direction. So, what's the best way you've ever found someone to guide you into a character as a director?
I worked with a director named Kate who directed episode 9, and she really changed things for me because she was just really watching. So on a close-up, if you're really there and really listening, like, hopefully you have an expressive enough face that people can just see it all there, and you don't have to show them that you are really listening, or, you know, it's all there. I mean, camera captures everything. So she would come in and she would give me an adjustment, and it would be so small, and she's like, don't do anything, think it. Okay, this is gonna work. And then she's like, I saw everything. What? And then we did another one, and the whole thing. I mean, I think every actor who's coming at film or TV acting from the theater background will have an adjustment to it. But something clicked. It only took me 3 seasons. That's what I'm saying. But it was really, really interesting to know that thinking is enough. And sometimes we have to learn that lesson more than once. It was just really awesome. She was the one who was really cool. She just directed her last episode of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., if you guys are catching up, the one in jail now. That was a pretty cool episode. It would have been better with me, but... Thanks.
Hi.
I was just wondering what your favorite candy was.
I will answer that. First of all, I want to apologize. Did Clark Gregg get to you? Did Coulson get to you? Because I see that your arm is in a cast there, and he's had a bad history with things against me, so you let me know, and I'll get that little robot hand off of him. My favorite candy, I like those Tootsie Rolls that are like different flavors. You know, the green ones and the orange ones, and the vanilla ones and the blue wrapper. Those are awesome. Yeah.
Thank you.
If you could be on any Marvel Netflix show, which one would you be on?
Ooh, that is a good question. Oh, man. Oh, they're all so good. Gosh. Jessica Jones.
We're like the Grant Ward variety of it.
I thought we were giving spoiler for
me. I saw the NDA. I'm sorry. I wasn't supposed to talk about
that. That's 2018. To make things short, were you aware that today's National Cast Day?
Yes.
Cast Day?
Cast.
Yes. I meant cast, and I was like, yeah, well, that would today's National Cast Day here in the States.
Go, Fred!
No!
Thank you for raising awareness.
No. That's awesome.
Hi.
Did you know I know?
Nobody got that.
Did you have a direction you wanted to take, Ward, before you found out you were IF?
That episode 9 that I was referencing earlier, was when I felt like I got him in a different way, and I was like, oh, this is so cool, this is so exciting. And it's happening midway through the season, so I'm like, yes, more energy, this is awesome, like, I get this guy, and then they killed me the episode after. thanks again, Colson.
So, we're out of time, let's do a lightning round real quick. Just burn through it, yes, no questions, all right? And go, keep it fast. This is not fast.
It's okay, we'll come back. We'll come back to you.
Yeah.
What's your favorite comic
book? Lobo.
Good yes, no question. Yes.
You maintain your relationships with everybody else from S.H.I.E.L.D. still and hang out with them? And
yes, I do. Yes, I do. My original family, I love them.
I just want to know what your favorite dance move is. That's all.
Like nothing that I can show you. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Cool. It was actually a dinosaur, and then they were like, yeah. Okay.
Hi, I was wondering, please tell me you're going to be at more conventions.
Yes, I am.
In Florida?
Puerto Rico?
In Florida?
In Florida? Requested with the organizers. Yes.
Do you want to come back in any more Marvel TV shows or movies?
Yes.